We're counting down to the start of trade here in the Philippines today. We're 2 minutes away, but Philippine shares yesterday charging back above 6,600 after gaining 0.6%, despite net foreign selling of nearly half a billion pesos. For more on the markets, we want to bring in Ron Acoba. He's chief investment strategist at Trading Edge Consultancy. Ron, welcome. Good morning.
Good morning, Min. Thank you for having me.
All right. Ron, when you look at where the PSEI is today, how solid is the runway for the stock market? We're back at 6,600. Would 7,000 be next? And I know you have been cautious for a while. So tell us, where are you today?
Well, before we get ahead of ourselves, let's just look back to how the PSEI performed a couple of weeks back. As you know, as you recall, the PSEI had recently pulled back to a low of 6.5 after it met a temporary resistance at around 6,700, which was actually its high back in May and July back in 2023. Although in the past 2 days, as you mentioned, that the PSEI has managed to climb and bring itself back above the 6,600 handle, primarily because of positive sentiment, mainly in the U.S. that brought the U.S. equities markets to new highs, has spilled over in the local scene. For me, looking back in the recent performance, what actually led to the recent pullback that I mentioned was profit-taking activities following a 6% rally since the Fed penciled in rate cuts for this year, and higher than expected CPI report in the U.S. For the month of December. Having said that, between today and the Fed monetary policy decision in March, not in Fed, but in March, I expect the index to just trade sideways between 6.5 and 6.7, primarily because I think investors would want to wait for validation whether the Fed would indeed start to cut their rates and make a monetary policy pivot. So we're not yet out of the woods. Though the way that I'm seeing it, I'm actually in the position that the PSEI would eventually clear the 6,700 level en route to its next key hurdle at 7.71. But before then, a consolidation will most likely take place in the near term.
So this consolidation, 6.5, is going to be a strong support, you think? We're not going to see or test lower lows?
Well, 6.4 is our major support. So thereabouts, 6.4, 6.5.
All right. Also, aside from central bank's watch, we are waiting for the earnings season to start rolling in. The U.S. has started. In Philippine earnings, we're going to get, it's always rear view mirror, you know, it's always a back view.
Exactly.
It's not forward looking. But what are you expecting to see? And more importantly, for Q4 and full year 2023, what will that tell you about, you know, Philippine consumers for 2024? Are you expecting, you know, Philippine consumers and spenders to run out of gas this year or to spend more, making companies even more bullish and aggressive to reinvesting or expanding?
So looking at the average earnings in the last three quarters that have been reported already, if you annualize them, you would actually come up to a double-digit earnings growth for corporates for 2023. Now, with inflation expected to ease for the present year and interest rates expected to ease as well, I'd expect consumer to continue to consumption to remain to be robust for the present year. Again, supported by decrease in the said hurdles. The way that I see it, the growth that we see last year, double-digit growth of around 13 to 15% on an annualized basis, we would actually continue more or less the same for 2024.
All right, 13 to 15% sounds decent. So aside from looking at the earnings, the top and bottom line, when you make a bet for 2024, is it small caps or big caps for you? Where are you placing your bets this year?
Well, looking at the bigger the bigger picture on how cycles go. Having said that, the main driver obviously of equity performance is interest rates. So we haven't really seen an improvement in domestic interest rates in the past couple of years, but we're looking forward to finally interest rates declining slowly but surely pretty soon. Having said that, obviously, following a decline in interest rates, there will be certain sectors that will benefit first, and these are the cyclicals. What are the cyclicals? These are the financial sector and the property sector. So I expect the bigger companies in those sectors to perform well, meaning the likes of BDO, BPI, and Metro Bank for the banking sector, and the likes of Ayala Land, SM Prime, and Robinson's Land for the property sector to benefit with a change in interest rate direction. Mm-hmm.
So you talk about cyclical stocks. What about tech stocks? I mean, I know that in the U.S. on Wall Street, it's really the Magnificent Seven, the mm-hmm. seven big tech names that are driving the rally. But here in the Philippines, we do have a listed tech company. It's Surpass. I'm sure you remember this from many years ago. We're having Surpass's chief technology officer on the show later. Anything on that front that you're excited about?
You mean the stock that reached a peak of 20 pesos and it's now doing 20, 30 cents? Unfortunately, it's not even in my monitor. It's not even in my screen. So I can't
see. Even if it's making a push into AI?
No.
All right. Let's talk about this.
I won't get into that hype until they prove anything back. Tangible.
All right. So we're all watching and waiting. But in the meantime, let's talk about this stock that you like, that you're monitoring, mm-hmm. that's on your monitor all the time. What do you have for us today? Don't tell us. Just describe. We're going to leave our viewers to guess what this is. What do you have for us?
Well, looking at the chart that it's in front of you, this stock has managed to mark a fresh 2-year high. It recently breached its 260 resistance last few days, and in the process of doing so, the stock has also managed to turn from a multi-year bullish reversal. As to what this stock is, it's a Philippine. We are known to be this company everywhere in the world. When foreigners talk about Filipinos, they talk about this particular brand, this particular restaurant. So that's the key.
All right.
So going back to how it performed in terms of technical analysis, following its recent move above the said 260 resistance, I believe it is now in position to reclaim its all-time high of around 324-325.
And at 324-325, is that fair value, or is that cheaper or expensive?
It's more or less fair value.
All right, we're just gonna have to guess which stock this is then. Thank you so much, Ron. Always a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you so much for the time and the insight. See you soon.
Likewise, Mimi. Thank you.
All right. Just before we go to the other news, wanted to bring in, we're 8 minutes into trade for the day. The PSE index is up by a fifth of 1%, 12 points. We're at 66.33. The broader all shares is also up by a tenth of 1%, 34.97. Most of the sectors are in positive territory, except for two. Financials down by a fifth and services down by a tenth. So it seems like we're joining what is expected to be an extended climb for Asian markets.